Hello, my name is David Pittman, and I'm the Director of Research and Development for the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, and I'm also the Director of the Engineer Research and Development Center. And I'm excited today to introduce the brand new Army Corps of Engineers R&D Strategy. It's brand new because we never actually had an R&D strategy before in the history of the Corps that covers our entire spectrum of operations. Our civil works programs, you know, leading the nation's navigation, flood risk reduction, and environmental, and our military mission, and our support for others. So it's a very bold new strategy that deals with all of these issues that the Corps is dealing with for this nation. So this brand new R&D strategy has 10 R&D priorities that we're focusing on. And as I talk through these 10 priorities, you're gonna see just how the major issues of the world it's addressing right now. Mitigate and adapt to climate change. You know, the whole world's dealing with climate change right now, so what are we doing to, you know, reduce greenhouse gases, to adapting our facilities to deal with sea level rise and storm surge, that sort of thing. We're a key part of the Army. We're part of the Department of Defense. It's a major part of what we do, and we're helping the Army and the Department of Defense come up with new ways of fighting the enemy no matter what they're gonna throw at us in the future. We got infrastructure crumbling around us. We gotta come up with innovative ways of introducing new technology to address all of those infrastructure issues that we're facing in the Corps and beyond. That's really what our entire Civil Works program is about, making our communities more resilient to storms, other issues that they're facing as we go forward, environmental issues, et cetera. So the Army installation strategy focuses on making our installations more resilient, more modern, and more focused on our soldiers and their families, plus acting as force projection platforms for all of our military. We want to help actualize the Army installation strategy. Of course, we do a tremendous amount of R&D with the environment. Tremendous work in our civil works program and our military programs. Trying to adapt to the environmental operating principles that we have in the Corps and how we work with nature in harmony with nature as we deliver our civil works and our military missions. We have an energy issue in the entire country, particularly on our installations right now. We need to reduce our energy demand and make it more green to help combat climate change and simultaneously meet the needs of our warfighter. That's all about using artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data analytics, robotics, all sorts of things that the world's using right now to revolutionize how the world operates. We gotta bring that into the Corps of Engineers as well on how we're helping and supporting the nation and delivering what the nation needs. So we all saw what happened at the Colonial Pipeline when nefarious actors in the world took control of some of our most precious infrastructure that we have on our own land here in the United States within our own borders. We can't have that at our military installations. So not only do we have to protect them physically, we have to protect them from cyber enemies as well, and bring that together on our installation. So we have a special capability in the Army Corps of Engineers in addressing issues in the Arctic, particularly a special research capability. And so as we protect the Arctic, it's on the leading edge of climate change and how we defend the Arctic itself. So as you can see, these 10 R&D priorities are very broad ranging. They're gonna require a lot of partnerships and how we get things done and how we deliver this. So in the Corps of Engineers, we'll need our partners in academia, in industry, other government agencies, even internationally, to get this bold new strategy accomplished. I look forward to working with you and partnering with you as we deliver this strategy.
I strongly feel that to achieve this vision, we must execute a comprehensive research and development strategy to meet the challenges of the 21st century. From climate change to warfighting, from overextended infrastructure to cybersecurity, there are no shortage of challenges that will require bold new research and development to solve.